Summer vacation is here and it is a perfect time to make memories with your kids. One of the ways is to go to the beach. Since we live in Arizona, we have to go to California, so it's a whole trip, but one of our favorite places is Crystal Cove. This is my absolute favorite picture of my kids. They're 5 years apart, but they would play for hours and hours at the beach, and we used to go there every year. So this picture encapsulates their close relationship, and as a mom, that is what we desire. But as a busy working mom, it can feel overwhelming to plan a beach day. So in this video, I'm going to show you how I've organized my beach bag, but I want you to find the best takeaways for you and how you can organize for a fun and relaxing day at the beach. This is my new beach bag. It's a bog bag. I chose the white color, extra large. I did have a couple beach bags before that I've had, I think probably like 15 years. And so, I mean, they're still on my channel somewhere. So anyway, this is the one that I got, and I decided to get this after seeing a whole bunch of reviews about it. I do love the bog bag because it is rectangular. And for me, that's just more of how I think. It may not be your preference, but get a beach bag that you like, okay? And whatever color you want. So here I just have a hand sanitizer. This is Touchland, and I bought the silicone holder with it. And it has a little key ring on the side which you can hook on. These bog bags, you can have like these clips, okay? And you can put anything on there. I also have another clip here that is a carabiner, and I just put this tassel keychain on there. That's just more for decoration, but of course you could use it for what it's actually made for, which is a keychain. And then I also got a couple pieces of decor, you know, and you can get the generic brand. So check out Amazon and different places. Look for the ones that kind of are your the price is palatable to you, because some of them are very expensive, which is, you know, was too much for me. But I got a set of three. The other one is on my pool bag, which is a rainbow, and I will do a separate video for my pool bag. And yes, I separate my pool bag and my beach bag. Okay, the main thing when you're organizing anything, even if it's just for a day at the beach, or if it's like a whole road trip, like for us when we want to go to the beach, is to organize by the way you think, okay? And so that's why I'm saying find the best takeaways from how I've organized my bag and see how it will integrate into how you think. And if it doesn't work, you can change it for next time. So one of the first things that you'll want in your beach bag is, of course, towels. And so these are just any type of beach towel. Now the good ones you want to have is the microfiber ones, because it's easier to get the sand off. So I have two of these, one for me and one for my husband. Okay, and then I also have this as far as you can have any type of towel for you and your kids, but I thought I would go ahead and get ones like these. So this one comes with a bag, and they're Turkish towels, specifically for the beach. They're larger, okay? And I won't be able to fit everything as far as what you can see on this video. So I've listed everything on an Amazon list, which is going to be in the description box. I also have it on my Amazon store, so check that out. I have listed absolutely every single thing that's in my beach bag. I hope if I miss something, just comment and let me know and I'll put it in there. Okay, so this is meant to be put on the sand, because usually at the beach there's no chairs, okay? And then these towels can be used as a pillow, right? And then of course for drying off, but if there's the four of us at the beach, then each of us can have one of these, right? They do have beach pillows, which I looked into, but I thought, you know what, I usually find a place where you can like put sand together, make some kind of pillow under your towel, but a beach pillow could be another thing, and that's like the relaxation category. Like, that's your base, that's your foundation. So that's definitely what you want to have. And although it sounds straightforward, of course you bring towels. The way I want you to think, and when you're organizing, is like, what's the foundation? You know, what are the essentials that you have to have? If you didn't have this, you know, you're gonna have a hard time at the beach without a towel, okay? Next thing is, I have this cup holder. So let me just kind of go through the bag. So it's not necessarily in order as far as like oh, you, these are like the total must-haves, and if you don't have this, you know, you think through it. I hope you get what I'm trying to say. But so it's easier for me for the video to just kind of show you around. So this is a cup holder, and I did have this in my video of my 10 must-haves, because for me, I always will have, whether it's water or sparkling water or whatever you want to drink at the beach, you have to have something to hold your drink, because you don't want it in the sand, and then you have to take it out of the sand and wipe it off. It's just a whole procedure, right? And this particular cup holder, okay, sorry for the angle. This is my first time filming this way. I actually have a standing desk that goes up and down. Luckily, I got this, my work gave this to me. I do have a job, I work from home. And that will be a whole nother series of videos I'll get to as far as how to be organized for working from home. Okay, so anyway, this one, you could put your cup here, it fits a Stanley cup, and then you can put your phone here. And so this cup part goes on the outside, right? Okay, you see that? The phone is here, and then the hooks is where I can put my keys, but it's inside the bag. So I just think this was really actually, I think whoever designed this is an organized person, because it makes a lot of sense. And of course, when you take the towels out, and there's gonna be space here for the bag. But I forgot to show you that. So just imagine your towels are here, and, okay, let me just fold this really quickly. Or roll it. So I do like to roll the towels. It's neither here nor there. It's up to you. But just imagine my towels are there. Okay. And so if you look at this space, you still have space here for like your packing cube, for your extra clothes, extra bathing suit, extra underwear, whatever you want. So when you're planning your beach bag, have space for that extra set of clothes. Minimal amount, you know, not like a whole suitcase, just enough, right? So like us, whenever we go to the beach, we always like to go to dinner afterwards somewhere nearby. And like I said, because we travel to go to the beach, it's a whole vacation. So for us, trying new restaurants is great. Eating beachside or with a view of the beach, that's one of the things that we always try to integrate when we go on a beach vacation. Okay, now you saw the inside, so what else? So the other, oh no, sorry, I don't want to look like I'm all over the place, but I am. Okay, so on the other side of the bag, which I love about the bog bag, okay, they're accessories to have stuff that you could put on, because this is very sturdy. Like if you put this on the sand, okay, your cup is here, it's not on the sand at all. You're lying down and you could just grab your drink and then put it back, right? You can have your sunglasses, put it back, right? This one is an accessory, so it's silicone, okay? And you could put whatever here, right? Maybe you wanna put some napkins so it's ready for you to wipe. You wanna put hand wipes in here, your hand sanitizer, whatever. Anything you wanna put in here, okay? Maybe you have a small enough tablet for when you read at the beach, or a book might fit in there. And here's another one. This one did not fit my phone, because my phone case is pretty thick. But can you see that close up? You can put your phone in there if you want to have a place to just set your phone that's not necessarily in the bag, if you're okay with that, because you're near your bag. And then this one is specifically for a can. Hold on. Okay, it's the perfect size for a canned soda. This is the 12 ounce, right? Look at that. Voila. Okay, when you say voila as a non-French speaking. Okay, look at that. That's amazing, I love that. So you can, you know, there's a bunch of holes here. So if you didn't want this one, but you want two in a row, so for you and someone else, you can have all four here. If you, however many, you could put them on the other side too, right? You can put more. And this is kind of like your glorified cup holder, okay? And here, this is a hat clip. I showed this on my 10 must-haves for the beach. And it basically, okay, there, it comes off like that. So, and it's a hat clip. Okay, so I have my beach hat here. Here's the clip. I clip it on. Okay, it holds it like that. And then I could hook it onto my beach bag. So while I'm walking and the wind is blowing and I'm carrying some other stuff, or you have a kid in one hand and you're carrying something, your beach bag in the other, or some, you know, a small cooler, you may not be able to hold onto your hat and it's a little bit windy. So you can have this and it carries like that. So a hat clip is great. All right, that's that. Let me show it to you like this. There, you can see that? And so I have this divider. That's the next thing I want to show you. It comes in a set of two. Okay, so these are made specifically for the bog bag because of the rectangular shape. And then these things move around. Those are what fit into these holes, okay? So if you have them vertical to be a divider here, you put these things here on the side to go into the hole. Now the other thing you can do is you can have it on top here, make sure you put in the holes, and it becomes like a little table, which I thought was genius, okay? These do not fit in the other bags that are similar to the bog bag because they're not rectangular. It's kind of hard. You can force it, it kind of stays up, but you do need these things to keep them in the holes, okay? All right, so that's that. Okay, I hope this view is okay. It's my first time filming this way, but okay. There, so let's look at what's in here. So when you have a big space like this, whether honestly in a shelf, a drawer, whatever, when it's kind of cavernous, like it's deep and wide, you want to put sections. So here I have two sections. That's why I love this divider. And then the rest kind of fits well enough. I didn't have to put, but if you want to put three sections with a second divider, you can do that. So over here, okay, I have this little bag and it came with the bag. It comes with this bigger one and then a smaller one. And then this small one does have the hole holders there. So it could hang here if you want, but I don't need to. But you can, like if you can hold it here, and when you get to the beach, you can attach it to the bag. So this is my electronics bag. So whether you have a bag that comes, a little bag like this, you need one for your electronics. So here I have a charger, okay? And then I have the spray for your, the screen spray. You just spray it. And this is a wiper and you wipe it down. Here, I'm trying to show you with my iPad. Okay, so you just spray it and then you wipe it. It's really great, it works great. Use it for your laptop and everything. And there's refillable solution. And then I like it because you can put it back into its case and it protects the wiper there. This one is just a cleaner. Okay, because it has a brush for your keyboard, screen wiper there. And then this is for AirPods. If you want to get into the nitty gritty of the AirPods. Where's my AirPods? Here's my AirPods holder. It's boba. But like if you want to clean in here, you know, in the holders and plus your AirPods itself, you can do that. And then here's the other side. Okay, sorry. So here, there's a little crevice here. You open it up. So you see how it can clean the inside. And then this one, it also has a little brush there. And you push this. This is to take out the keys of the keyboard, and then here's to brush in between. And then it comes with its container, and you're like, why would you bring that to the beach? Hey, listen, some people bring their laptops or whatever electronics to the beach, and you got the time, and it's, you got the time to clean, go ahead and clean it there, right? You got all day at the beach to do that. Okay, so that would go up here. Now the other thing I have in here is a first aid kit. So I would definitely say with kids, you need to have some sort of basic first aid kit, you know, for like scratches, bandages, Neosporin, if you want to add some over-the-counter medication, or maybe they have medication, or you have your vitamins, whatever. So this particular kit, very popular, Bling Sting, says in there, Kiss It Better. It has 75 items in there, which is good enough for like basic first, very, very basic first aid. But here I add like some over-the-counter medication. Okay, and I love it. I love this case. I love how it snaps. I love things that snaps, but don't snap at me, okay? This is a pill organizer. It comes with a large and then a small. The small one is in my pool bag, but it's magnetic here, okay? And I have here, and I label it. Okay, so like Halls, belly, I always need Halls. My throat is always dry. But you could put other things here like hair bands, bobby pins, whatever you feel like at this moment. I really don't have anything else to put in there. I was thinking of using the smaller one, but I figured I'll go ahead and keep the larger one in case I want to add more stuff, because it takes the same amount of space whether I fill this up or not. Okay, and so see how when you're organizing, how everything has its own bag. And you know, that may seem obvious, but that's the thing to think about. It's like, how do you want to corral and categorize your things? So like electronics, pills, first aid kit. Okay, and then this one, I love this bag. Look at sardines. It comes in different colors. Like I said, I have everything listed below. It has a little tab, like the sardine tab. I love sardines. So this is my bathroom supplies. So if we're going to use the restroom, and not all beaches are equal as far as the public restrooms. So some may not have toilet seat covers. So that's one of the things I definitely want to have, is a toilet seat cover. And if you, I have, you know, like a spray, like Poopery, makeup remover wipes, hand lotion. I have this lip balm, which is so cute. You just unscrew it like this, and that's a lip balm. This flavor is Pina Colada. It comes in different flavors. I love it. Okay, body wipes. And look how easy it is to take out and put in. Make sure you have a bag that kind of opens up. Okay, deodorant wipes. Facial wipes. You know, when you're at the beach, like you may start to feel stinky. It was a little bit too hot for your preference, and you want to freshen up at the end of the day before you go out for dinner. Sometime in between, it's up to you. You can put more than one. You can put a couple, right, or more, depending on the size, the space that you have in your bag. Facial wipes. Okay, and then I have here a stain remover, and that's for like, you know, if you any kind of stain, right? But if you need tampons, these are Stallmates for wiping, feminine wipes. Okay, and then I have, what's that called? Mouthwash. And as far as washing your hands, you know, like I said, on the other side, I have my hand sanitizer. Okay, so if they don't have soap in the public restroom, you always have your hand sanitizer. But if you want to put a little bit of travel soap in here, you can. Whatever you want, it's up to you. Whatever you and your kids, your family needs, that's what you put in your bag. So think about, if I were to go to the restroom at the beach, what would I need? Whether it's my time of the month, it's not, or if I might not be feeling so well, whatever, what would you bring? For your kids, what would you want them to have? If they were to go to the restroom, have that little bag with them, what would they need to bring? Okay, so here, okay, so now let's look at the main compartment. This one, this big, the white bag that goes in here, it's kind of hard to show. Maybe I'll take it. Yeah, see how easy it is to take out, and it's easy to put in. So here's the bag, okay, and it's clear. I love that it's clear. I have this powder patch, which you take out. It's powder to take off the sand. You wipe it off, okay? That was one of my tricks when my kids were little. Like, how to take sand off of their feet before going into the car was powder. But back then, I just have the powder that comes, that you shake out of the bottle, and this is perfect because the powder doesn't go all over the place. And the powder pouch has its own pouch. Okay, I have here a wet bag, so you need enough wet bags for everybody. Oops. I have my mini fan, so watch my other video of my 10 essentials to show you how this mini fan works, or else this video will get so long. Towel clips. Okay, and then I have Noon. This is a, what do you call it? It's a hydration, you know, drink tablet, electrolyte drink tablet, and I put in my water 1 to 2 a day because I drink a lot of water. It has really, I mean, in 2 summers, oh no, I shouldn't say 2 summers, in a whole year, I've had a headache maybe twice. But before, I used to have headaches all the time, but it's lack of hydration, right? Okay, this one, you're gonna laugh at me. But my back is always itchy, like all the time, okay? And so I have a travel back scratcher. Oh yes, oh my gosh, listen, when I need to scratch my back and I'm in the airplane, it's horrible. Anywhere, my back is always itchy. I don't care how much lotion I put on it. Okay, and it's hard to put lotion on your back, so my husband always has to do it for me, but anyway, here I also have a bottle can opener, just a basic one. Sometimes you get these for free, right? So just stick one inside your bag. I know that most of the time alcohol is prohibited at the beach, but you can use it for other things, right? You're like, what else can I use it for? Well, you can, gosh, I have a whole list and I forgot it. Anyway, it has like, I don't know, whatever you can use it for. You can let me know in the comments below what else would you use it for. I had a list, but now I forgot any of all of them. There's a handful. I'm not saying there's a whole lot of stuff. I think there was one where you can get rid of a hangnail, which is kind of interesting. All right, so look at how easy, when you're organized, it's easy to put everything back because everything has its place, right? And however it makes sense to you, so you're like, why wouldn't I put the wet bag in another bag? Why does it all go together? Well, it goes together for me. This is kind of my miscellaneous bag. Let's say it's not toiletries, it's not food, it's not electronics. So I put them in this particular bag. Okay, look how fast it is to put this in. Like literally, what was that? 10 seconds? Oops, this one's a little stuck. Okay, there, that took a little while. So now this is my other bag and it says travel on there. I love these bags. These are great. I think they're like, you'll see in the description how big they are, but I think they're about 11 inches. So let me just show you what I have in here. So these are kind of like, whatchamacallit, kind of like a refreshing, you know, like kind of spa stuff, right? Not my makeup bag, because my makeup bag is separate. So I have my sunscreen. Okay, I just draped this to see, maybe you could see it better. Okay, so this one is aloe. So, you know, for those when it's too much in the sun, when you're too much in the sun. This is perfume. It's a body spray. I shouldn't say perfume. It's amazing. Has amazing reviews. So I have one in almost every one of my kits. So, and it's a perfect size, 3 full ounces. This is a spray for the face. So this is the part where you think about yourself, you know, like if my kids are playing there at the beach and I take a picture of the perfect picture, my favorite picture of all time, but I'm laying at the beach, what do I wanna do? I wanna read, I wanna listen to music. I wanna have my spa moments. And so these are your spa moments, right? This is rechargeable. It's a mister. You just put water in here. It has a little bit of a mirror. And then push it down. Look, it's a mister. Oh, it's amazing. Thank you for whoever thought of that. Okay, here I have a peppermint oil roller because I do get hot. I'm at that point in my life where I'm always hot. Tissue paper. Okay, so you can put something like this in that makeup bag when you bring it to the public restroom in case they don't have toilet paper. Okay, this is a dental floss because you know you're always eating at the beach. And so it holds 10 of these dental floss picks, right? I mean, don't you get, I have to open this up to put it back in. But don't you eat something and then it's inevitable that something sometimes gets stuck in your teeth. Okay, Clorox wipes for those messy things. Okay, makeup holder with the sponge. Okay, and this came actually with two sponges, which is great. Again, the links are below. And it came with a matching, it came with a matching makeup bag, but I'll show you that in a little while. And then I have a scrunchie for the times when I just don't want just a hair tie. And then I have a compact mirror, and these are things that you're gonna put everywhere in every kit and every travel thing that you have. So it opens up, has a mirror, right? And then the brush opens like that. And they do provide a little packet to wipe the mirror, right? And so let me show you how easily, how putting it in, you know where everything is that you want, how easy it is to put in. It's just less than, not, doesn't take a lot of time, okay? Try to put taller things in the back. It's hard to hold that up. I have to bring this up. Okay. And then my mirror there. Oops. And I love that style because it's like the beach. And then my makeup sponge up here at the top. Okay, travel. Okay, and then look how nicely that fits in there. Right, it's just nice and snug. Okay, this is the matching makeup bag, silicone also. It closes with magnetics, and it did come with its own brushes, but you can have your own brush. And I don't bring a lot of makeup. I mean, my main makeup thing are my lashes, which I probably don't wear to the beach, but I might wear it after when we go out for dinner. Okay, these are containers. They're square, they're kind of, yeah, they're like metal, and then they have these kind of rubber band type of holders there. And so you've probably seen these all over social media, but you press it, it comes out, opens pretty wide. And the nice thing is above, it's clear so you can see what's in there, and there's a lot of space in here. So this is where I keep my hair ties. I have a headband there, and then I have some bobby pins. I could put the scrunchie in here, but I didn't like how it kind of packed it up. So since there was space in my travel bag, I went ahead and put it there. And here's another one where I put, look at these, are darling. They're mini Tic Tacs. And then this is actually a perfume spray. So you could do whatever body spray or perfume you have and fill it up. This is refillable, so you can use it over and over. This is one of the best things I have for when I travel. Okay, it looks like that. You spray, okay. And it comes in all different colors and in a set. Now this one too, I could have it here with my other sprays, my facial spray and my mister. But since I have space here, and this may not work for you because you're like, ew, body spray next to Tic Tac. So don't do it, you know, do it another way. It's perfectly fine. If I wanted to probably put more gum and mints and stuff, I could put it here. Okay, and down way, way at the bottom is our snack box. Okay, and you have seen this. You have seen this on social media. It's amazing. I did have a little scratch here already, but I'm not gonna fill this up. I'll just put up pictures here so you can see what you could fill it up with. But you could do like a charcuterie with grapes, strawberries, nuts, salami, crackers, or you could do a, you know, a fun one for kids where a treat, like they can have gummy worms, gummy bears, sweet and sour patch kids, or whatever they're called, fruit, Chex Mix, Cheez-It, different crackers, you know, whatever you eat. And if one of your kids, let's say, is like my kid, one of them is can't have any type of nuts, we can make a whole separate one that is nut free, or you can do a whole gluten free, whatever. The reason this is great is because it's clear, you can see it. Look how thick it is, and there are 8 containers in there. So you have 8 possibilities of what you could put in, 8 different categories, like 4 types of fruit, 4 types of snacks, whatever. And they come out easily. Okay. And so let's say one is needs to be refilled. You can just take one out, refill it, put it back in, right? And you can have it ready for your trip, right? Let's say you go to the beach day and then you didn't eat all of it. Like you just take it out and you refill it. The other thing is that it snaps really well and it holds. It snaps tight. I love it. And all 4 sides. And then it has this handle that goes up like that, which is perfect for carrying. Okay. And the reason I like this is because it goes down too. So if you had a bag for snacks and it was just the handle is sticking up, you know, it's not space efficient. So this is great because it really saves space and it fits perfectly down there. Look at that. I mean, did they do this on purpose? Whoever made the snack box, they're like, okay, let me make one just specifically for the bog bag. All right, so this is my bag. What are some things to take away from this? You know, you have organized for your family, organize for how you think. I say that all the time. There are things here that you're like, yes, you know, I definitely need to have that, but that's not the brand that I like. Well, then you get the different brand, but you have the same, you know, the same purpose, whether it's the wipes or the makeup, the charger, maybe the decor. You're like, oh, I don't need decor. Well, then don't get decor. Or instead of the decor on the other side, I have a bigger family, so I really need more cup holders. Well, then do that, okay? Or like this cup. This actually can fit another cup next to it. I'm debating whether to get another one for my husband, okay? Or for whoever. Maybe I'm going to the beach with my girlfriends and I want to have some, a cup available for at least one of them, okay? And the hat clip, maybe, oh, you know what? We probably need more hat clips because I have my straw hat, my husband has a baseball cap, or I want my kids to wear hats, whatever, right? Okay, get the quantity that you need, but consider the space because if you get too many cup holders, it may not all fit, but you know, look, it can fit at least 3 here, maybe 4. Okay, you may be thinking, oh, you know what? We like to shower at the beach before we go. So I need maybe some soap, you know, the outdoor shower where you water down. But some people I see, like, they actually soap and they actually use shampoo. Well, then bring a bag for that. So you saw me, as I was talking about what's in this bag and how I've organized it, you saw me putting things away. So you can see at the end of your beach day, when you have an organized bag and it's just the things that you need and maybe a little bit more, you know, a little bit of that spa moment in this bag going on, you can see how easily it goes back together because it's organized, because everything has a place. There's a purpose for everything that you've put in here. And look how nice and neat that looks even after a whole day of using it, right? Just pretend we just came from the beach. We're at the beach, we're packing up. We're a little bit sunburned. Maybe luckily you got a little bit of a suntan. You're relaxed. You read a couple chapters in your book. Took a few selfies. You have that perfect picture of the kids that will forever be part of your heart and your memories. You had some good sparkling water. You didn't get a headache. The run to the public restrooms wasn't bad at all. Okay? And you just had a great time. A great fun, relaxing day at the beach is what I want you to have. So let me know in the comments how you organize your beach bag or what takeaway you got from this video and what you're going to implement into your beach bag and how you organize it. And if you want to see my top 10 essentials for my beach bag, watch the next video.